press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, we have been discussing about the chapter electric current and its effects. And so far we have learned in our previous classes what is this electric current, and we have also seen what are its major effects caused by this electric current. Okay, electric current is nothing but the flow of charges. Okay, the charges is nothing but the electrons, right? The flow of electrons constitute the electric current. Okay, and we have seen when the current is produced, a little amount of heat is also produced. Okay, so that is nothing but the heating effect of electric current. Okay, and we have also seen, even though there is no magnet present around this circuit, electric circuit or electric current, when this current flows, there is a bit magnetic field created around this current carrying wire. Okay, so this is the magnetic effect of electric current. Okay, so we have learned about these two effects, that is heating effect of electric current and also magnetic effect of electric current. Okay, and this magnetic effect of electric current was first shown by the scientist Oersted. Okay, now let us study more on this magnetic effect. Okay, where all this magnetic effect is used. Okay, so let us study about this electromagnets. Okay, so what are these electromagnets? Okay, as the name says, electromagnets. Here the magnetism, okay, the magnetic field is created due to the electricity. Okay, electromagnet is nothing but magnets in which electric current produces magnetic field. Okay, so here we don't have permanent magnets, okay, the actual magnet. Okay, so here we have a material around which the magnetic field is created. Okay, the magnets in which the magnetic field is created, not because of the magnet, okay, because of the electric current produced. Okay, so that kind of magnets are called electromagnets. Okay, here there a core will be present, okay, and around it the wire will be coiled. Okay, and this is the wire. And when the current is produced here, okay, when the current is produced, this acts as a magnet. Okay, here magnetic field is created. Okay, it attracts the iron nails or any other magnet or something. Okay, it acts like a magnet due to the production of current. Okay, so this is the electromagnet. Okay, and the thing is when electric current is produced, okay, when electric current is on, okay, magnetic field, okay, when current is on, magnetic field is produced. Okay, and when this current is off, this magnetic field is not produced. Okay, so here the magnetic field wholly depends on this electric current. When current is on, there is magnetic field surrounding the coil. Okay, and when the current is off, there is no magnetic field produced. Okay, so this wholly depends on this electric current. And the advantages of this electric current over the normal permanent current is that permanent magnets, what they have, okay, we cannot control the magnetic field around them. Okay, when we have a magnet, we cannot control that magnetic field. Okay, it will be having a magnetic field surrounding it, right? But here we can easily control. Okay, whenever we want, we can make use of this magnetic field, and whenever we don't want, we can just switch off the current. There won't be any magnetic field surrounding it. Okay, so here, the advantage is that with our convenience, okay, with our needs, we can use this magnetic current by switching on and off this current. Okay, so this is about electromagnet. Okay, let me show you an example or an activity, you can say, where you can clearly know about this magnetic field, how can it be produced. Okay, here we have a simple circuit diagram again. okay, and here the current is flowing. Here we have a switch. Okay, since we have to produce this current, the switch is on, it means we need to draw a closed circuit. Okay, and here what we do is, here we will keep a nail. Okay, here we keep a nail, and to that we'll, you know, surround, we'll coil this wire. Okay, and we'll join this wire here. Okay, we have a cell here. Clear? We have a cell here. We have a switch. We have on this. This is closed circuit, as you can see. To produce a current, our switch is on. Okay, and this is a nail. We have surrounded this nail with this current carrying wire. Okay, and we'll keep a few iron pieces. Okay, we'll keep some iron pieces here. Okay, now, okay, now we'll switch on this. Okay, so while I switch on this, what happens is, whenever there is when the current is on, yes, we have known that when the current is on, there is a magnetic field produced around this wire. Okay, so with that, because of this magnetic field produced here, okay, this acts as a magnet. Okay, so this nail act as a magnet, and whatever the iron filings I have kept here, okay, the small iron pieces, it gets attracted to the nail. Okay, since it acts as a magnet, okay, the iron iron filings, iron pieces, okay, it gets attracted to this. Okay, if this is a wire, yes, here I have kept the iron filings. Yes, now this iron filings gets attracted to this nails. Okay, why? Because this acts as a magnet. Okay, now we can say this is an electromagnet. Okay, because we can easily control the magnetic field surrounding this with the current flowing. Okay, we have switched on, that's why this attracted, and when we switch it off, this iron pieces, okay, just leaves this magnet. There won't be any magnetic field attracting this nail. Okay, sorry, the iron pieces which I have kept here. Okay, clear? So when there is no more, when this not any more current current given, okay, to this nail. Okay, here it doesn't act as a magnet because of because of no magnetic field produced around it. When I have switched it on, only then it acts as magnet. Okay, we can clearly see it attracts this iron nails. When you switch it off, it repels. Okay, the iron filings falls down, it moves away. Okay, so this, by this activity we can say that, yes, okay, these electromagnets are controlled by this electric current, of course. Okay, and let us see, where do we use this electromagnets. Okay, let us see, where is this used? Okay, these are used in cranes. Okay, you might have seen in supermarkets, in big garages or something, there will be this vehicle, okay, which carries big iron boxes, iron materials or heavy boxes, something like that. It carries up and down. Okay, so here there on the surface of that carrying material, electromagnet is present, okay, which attracts these iron boxes or heavy boxes, so that it's easy to carry the whole load. Okay, so in trains, also in magnetic separators. Okay, even in magnetic separators, hard disks, loudspeakers. Okay, and also MRI machines, motors, ठीक है। इंडक्शन हीटर्स, इलेक्ट्रिक बिल्स, ओके ओके। सो दीज आर द एप्लीकेशंस और द यूजेस वेयर वी कैन यूज दिस इलेक्ट्रो मैग्नेट्स, ओके। वी कैन यूज दिस इन क्रेन्स, मैग्नेटिक सेपरेटर्स टू सेपरेट द मैग्नेट्स एंड द हार्ड डिस्क, ओके, एंड ऑल्सो इन द लाउड स्पीकर्स, MRI मशीन्स, मोटर्स, इंडक्शन हीटर्स, ओके, इंडक्शन कुकिंग वेयर्स वॉट वी यूज इन आर डेली वेज, ओके, सो दैट इवन द इलेक्ट्रिक बल्ब, ओके, सॉरी इलेक्ट्रिक बिल्स, ओके। सो दीज आर द एप्लीकेशंस और द यूजेस वेयर वी कैन see the use of this electromagnets, okay. Now let us study now in detail about these electric bells. So let us study in brief about this electric bells, okay. These electric bells, I hope, I'm sure you all have seen, okay, there's this bell kept in offices, okay, officers in your school principal chambers or something, okay, they'll just press it, it makes a sound, and people around it or someone who is working there will come inside and ask them what do they need or something, okay. This is a bell thing present, when you press it, it makes a sound, right? So that is an electromagnet, okay. We'll see how it works, okay. Before that, let us see the construction, okay. Okay, so its construction is something like this. Here we have a switch, okay. Here we have a cell. So this is the construction, okay. So this is the inside of the bell. Actually, to look, the bell just looks like this, okay, as a round color, round surface, and here a red button is present, okay. This is exactly how bell, not exactly, something similar how bell looks like, okay. Here it's a round surface, it will be having a base, and when you press this button, okay, it makes a sound, okay. So this is it, how it looks, but this is its construction, okay, to show you how it exactly works. Okay, so here in this construction we have wires, okay. These are the wire connections, what you can see here, and yes, the wires are useful in connecting the switches to cells, batteries and all, okay. Okay, so this is the wire, okay, this is the wire, and here we have an iron piece, okay. So this is the iron piece, okay. This is the wire and this is the iron piece, okay. Even this is the iron piece here, okay. Okay. So, see, this is the wire, okay? So, this is the wire connected to this iron piece, okay? So, this is the iron piece, what you can see here. Okay, this is the iron piece and to this wire is coiled, okay? So, this part is nothing but the electromagnet, okay? Here we have now a core, okay, to which a wire is coiled, okay? So this is the one which acts as electromagnet. Okay, now this is the electromagnet, okay? This whole structure, iron piece with the coiled wire, got it? This is the electromagnet and here we have the iron strip, okay? This is the iron strip. And here, okay, so here we have a contact screw. Okay, so this is the hammer. Okay, so these are all the parts what we have in the electric bell. Okay, so now let us see about the working of this electric bell. Okay, so this is the construction, how it looks like inside. Now let us see about the working, okay? So when the switch is on, okay, when there is a current passed, okay, what happens due to this flow of electric current, okay? So listen carefully, due to this flow of electric current, okay, here to this iron piece, the wire is coiled, right? This acts as electromagnet. Okay, so what is electromagnet? It is a magnet in which the magnetic field is produced due to the electric current, right? Here electric current is passed and here we have electromagnet, okay? Since we have electromagnet here and when current is passed, here surrounding this a magnetic field is created, okay? So surrounding this electromagnet, a magnetic field is created. Okay, when there is a magnetic field, it will attract, right? It will attract the other magnets or the closest iron particle present near it, right? So when we have an electromagnet here and when the current is flowing, a magnetic field is created around this, okay? Due to that magnetic field present, this iron strip, okay? So this iron strip, okay, attracts to this electromagnet, okay? So this iron strips attracts to this electromagnet. This iron strip moves towards this, okay? And when it's moving, this it is a contact screw, okay? This will be attached initially, okay? So this is the contact screw, okay? And here when this iron strip is moving, this part loses connection, okay? So when this part loses connection, okay, this part loses connection as this iron strip is moving, and because of which when this part is moving, the hammer is also moving, okay? So that's what hammer, when iron strip is getting attracted to this electromagnet, here the hammer gets, you know, hits to this gong, okay? This is the hammer, this hits to this gong, okay? And when this hammer hits to this gong, that is when the sound is produced, got it? And yes, so here the contact is, you know, removed, okay? Here it is no more in contact, okay? When this iron strip is moving here it is not in contact, okay? Even the hammer, you know, moves, okay? That's when it hits the gong and sound is produced, okay? And now you can see here it is a open circuit, okay? Before it was closed circuit, due to which the current passed and electromagnet started acting. Okay, it created a magnetic field around and here the iron strip got attracted, okay? And when this iron strip got attracted to this electromagnet, the contact is loosened here, okay? It is removed, okay? So this acts as an open circuit now, okay? So when this is an open circuit, remember current flows only when it is closed circuit, okay? When this moves towards this electromagnet, there is no more it is not anymore a closed circuit, okay? It's an open circuit, okay? So that's when your current stops producing, okay? When there is no current, okay? When there is no current, again there is no work of this electromagnet, right? Because it works only in the presence of current, okay? The magnetic field is created only when the current is passed, okay? Since it is open circuit now, what happens? no more current means no more magnetic field. Okay, when there is no magnetic field, this iron strip doesn't get attracted anymore. Okay, so again what happens, it moves back. Okay, so when this moves back, okay, again the hammer loses connection with the gong. Okay, so when it just gets contact again. Okay, so again when it's, you know, it gets into a closed circuit, again the current is passed, and this is how the process repeats. Okay, so again the process repeats. Okay, so here the main thing you have to remember is here the electric bulb works only because of this electromagnet. Okay, see, and one more use is, here we cannot use any permanent magnet. Okay, we need something which, you know, we can conveniently use whenever we want. Okay, but permanent magnets is all the way they'll be having a magnetic field around it. So okay, so for that reason we cannot use permanent magnet here. Instead we use electromagnets. Okay, so this is the electromagnet. Okay, let me repeat once here. When this current is flowing, okay, so initially this is in contact. Okay, remember this is a contact screw. Okay, here we have an initial contact. Okay, listen carefully, here we'll be having an initial contact. Okay, now see, this is a closed circuit. Now we have a switch, we have a cell. Okay, then the current is flowing since it is a closed circuit. Okay, when the current is flowing, due to this flowing current, this is an electromagnet. See, we have a core and a wire coiled to this. Okay, so this acts an electromagnet. Okay, in these electromagnet, magnetic field is created. Okay, magnetic field is produced only because of this electric current. Okay, due to this flowing electric current, electromagnets comes into force and generates a magnetic field around it. Okay, so when there is magnetic field surrounding this electromagnet, this iron strip gets attracted. Okay, so this gets attracted to this electromagnet. Okay, and when this is moving, okay, this makes the hammer move. Okay, so this makes the hammer move, and this hammer hits to the gong. Okay, now this is where the sound is produced, when the hammer hits the gong. Okay, and when the contact, okay, so here when the iron strip is moving, the contact is removed, the contact is loosened. Okay, so it hits. Now soon after the contact is loosed, current stops flowing because it is an open circuit now. Okay, there is no current. Okay, and when there is no current, an electromagnet does not comes into force, and it does not present any produce any magnetic field around it. Okay, when there is no magnetic field, again this iron strip goes back to its initial position. Okay, and again it gets connected. Okay, and again the hammer goes back to its normal position. Okay, so again it gets connected, so again the process repeats. Okay, so here the whole working depends on this electromagnet. Got it? So this is the working of electric bell, which is basically based on the working process of this electromagnet. Okay, so with this it completes your chapter. Okay, in the next class we'll discuss a new chapter. Okay, in this chapter, that is electric current and its effects. Okay, we have learned about the electric current, isn't it? We have learned where we use this electric current, about the circuit diagrams, about the circuit symbols. We have learned about the various circuit symbol used for this: cells, batteries, wires, switch on, switch off, right? So these are all circuit symbols we have used. Okay, and why do we exactly use circuit symbol is because every time when I showed the circuit diagram, I wrote a simple, okay, just a switch, a cell and a bulb. Okay, every time it's not that easy. Okay, in different electric appliances the circuit is more complex, it keeps on getting complex, right? So in that, every circuit diagram you cannot write whole bulb, battery, cells and everything. Okay, so that's the reason we use just a simple symbols, okay, for our convenience, right? So circuit diagrams are nothing but the pictorial representation of flow of electric current. Okay, and in effects we have seen about the two effects, that is heating effect of electric current and also magnetic effect of electric current. okay. For example, yes, when there is a bulb, okay, when there is a bulb glowing, when you keep your hand near that bulb, you feel, feel somewhat hot, okay, your palm, your hand feels hot. It is because that electric current produces heat, okay, so that is nothing but heating effect of electric current, okay. In that application, we have seen about this fuses, how fuse works, and about the miniature circuit breakers, okay. These two, fuse and miniature circuit breakers, these are used when there is, these are safety devices, okay. These are used when there is overflow of electric current, okay. So to prevent that overflow, okay, to prevent the destruction or the spoilage of other electric appliances, we use these fuses and miniature circuit breakers, right? And we have learned one more effect of electric current, that is magnetic effect. That was shown first by Oersted. He is the scientist who showed, okay, even there is no magnet produced around the circuit, still there is some magnetic field produced, okay, that is because of this electric current, okay. So that was shown by this Oersted, and in that magnetic effect we have seen about the electromagnets and electric bulbs, right? Electromagnets are the one which, even there is no magnetic presence around, because of the electric current they produce a magnetic field around, due to which the substance, okay, in any other magnet or iron filings or iron materials, they get attracted, okay. On that we have seen the marking basis of this electric bell, clear? So this is all about the chapter electric current and its effect. Thank you.